Chris.
Crafty, you want to video?
May I just start off by saying a very warm welcome, and it is just fabulous to see so many people here. I might also say congratulations, Graham and Sue, and I look forward to working with you. So we are really pleased now to have the G train complete. It's just fabulous. So as you, through your associations with me, Brian and Graham, I'm sure and I hope we'll be able to help you with your club management and organisation. The first thing I would like to do is, Alex, would you please show the video clip? This is just a small video clip of our President-elect, Ian Martin.
The power of Rotary that we all experience every single day. The power to make a difference for those who need us. Now, making a difference is an expression you hear all the time about Rotary. The opportunities that we have and the things that we do. And that's why we're all here at this assembly, to make a difference to our world, to our communities, and to the lives of others. And in 2017-18, that will not only be our goal, but our theme, Rotary Making a Difference. Now, what kind of a difference each club and each Rotarian chooses to make will always be their own decision. But we're united in our organisation and its common principles, our insistence on ethics and our commitment to service above self. As an individual, what could I have done? What could any of us have done to help those children from Germany? We wouldn't even have known. But through Rotary, even in my small club in Sandringham, we were able to make a real difference. In Rotary, we know that we can do more together than we could ever hope to do alone. It's the principle on which our service is based, and it's true at every level of Rotary. All of us here this week are, and must be, a team, as I mentioned last night. We're united in our common goals of moving our organisation forward and ensuring its lasting future. I ask you to keep that spirit of teamwork and cooperation always in your mind and take it back with you to your districts. Let me emphasise again that the year ahead of us, all of us, is not just our year of leadership. Our job is to make it Rotary's year to shine. It's the year all of us have committed to dedicate to service through Rotary. It is Rotary making a difference by building stronger and more active clubs that serve in better and more lasting ways. It is believing in a Rotary that is recognised for the good work it does, a Rotary that will continue to grow, to endure, to go from strength to strength, making a difference to our communities, our countries, our world and ourselves. This is what we will achieve together next year, Rotary Making a Difference. Thank you. That was the...
Second round. Thank you very much, Alex. As you can see, the theme for this year, Rotary Making a Difference, is simple. Deliciously simple. It is not and Rotary made a difference. It is not Rotary might make a difference. It is not Rotary used to make a difference. It is not Rotary will make a difference. It is Rotary making a difference. It is current. We do that now. But what President-elect Ian has emphasised is that we continue doing that, Rotary making a difference. And as such, the logo for this theme, which is lovely and bright and colourful, Ian has described as such, and I need to read it. Basically, it symbolises diversity, with people from all races and backgrounds uniting under the banner of Rotary to make a difference. It symbolises all of us striving together to do better, reaching ever higher to do good in the world in the name of Rotary. Now, basically, we do that already. So we are just going to continue doing that for this 12 months. The plan for President-elect Ian is very simple. He likes simple, it suits me, I like simple, it works. So there are three basic things that he would like us to do. Support and strengthen clubs, focus and increase humanitarian service, and enhance public image and awareness. Now, as you can imagine, all those three things are absolutely critical if we want Rotary to survive over the next 100 years. I won't be here in 100 years, but it is important that the service of Rotary is. So for us to be able to enthuse and encourage that to happen, the support and the strengthening of the clubs from the district is absolutely critical. Many of you will understand that we have a problem with membership, and this is one of the reasons that the Rotary International is talking about redistricting. They get very excited about membership in Chicago. So we are here to help them with their excitement and to generate more people. And I have confidence, great confidence, that over the next 12 months, we will be able to increase our membership by at least 50 people, which means, very simply, one member per club over a period of 12 months of time. So the district is here to help support that. And as part of that structure, on the 17th of September this year, we will be having a membership forum, and I would encourage you all to attend it. Certainly the presidents, we spoke about it yesterday, but certainly the membership directors. More details will be coming up about that shortly. But that is going to be an opportunity to share ideas and to look at promoting membership within the district. We have budgeted for it in the budget that was passed yesterday, so there is money available to do that. Focus and increase humanitarian service is critically important, and we do that very well now. And enhance public image and awareness is something that is essential if we want Mr. and Mrs. Public to recognise Rotary for what it is. Again, there is money in the budget to allow this to happen. So we will be looking at working with the district public relations chair, Jordan Fallon, who is going to work to promote Rotary. It doesn't have to be high profile stuff, but there is a lot of simple things that we can do to promote Rotary. And one of the easiest things that I think is, every time we're out in the public doing something, there needs to be a big sign saying Rotary Club of whatever, so that they people know that Rotary is the primary service organisation in this district. So it's really important that we continue that enthusiasm of public awareness. However, as we drill down onto these three goals, it's important that you understand a little bit about the structure of Rotary. And one of the things that is very important to me is that you understand that you as clubs sit at the apex. The rest of us, the G Train, the district, Rotary International, we're down here. But the clubs are the driving force of Rotary. And without the clubs and without you, we wouldn't be here. So I do encourage you to push that Rotary enthusiasm in every opportunity you get.